version of this is known as a collector of art. He's kind of collected in two realms. He's been very interested in the fine arts, but he's also been very interested in all the artwork that's been produced around Star Wars. And he had the idea of just seeing how much Star Wars had inspired the artists who do our products to bring fine artists into the world of Star Wars and to create a collection of artwork based on Star Wars as interpreted by the fine artists of today. The goal of the project was to really find some of the best fine artists working today, wherever that they might be. We have artists from the United States, from Europe, from Japan. It's quite far flung and a very interesting assortment, both of nationalities and styles.
Each one of these people that have been selected for the exhibition is top-notch. In the case of Will, I've known him for 30 years, and I've watched him grow. And the one thing I know is that each subject, each painting, he brings history. I mean, he studies the surroundings of it, he studies the particulars that are going to be in it, and he brings it together in a way that you would never expect.
That same night that I got the call to do a painting, I had a kind of a dream of this red baby kind of riding around in a cradle of heels. Like, I thought, when I woke up and I told my wife, I said, I want to paint Darth Maul as a baby. And then that morning, the photograph took about 200 pictures of this baby. And there was this one photograph where she was holding her hands up. Her hand was in this position, which I later found out is for sign language, the universal symbol for love. And I just love the idea of the dichotomy, the contradiction that is Star Wars, the Force, you know. It's no good and evil, it's just like they have to function together, like the yin and yang. And so Darth Maul, this pose of evil presence, pulling up the universal symbol for love, is just perfect. You know, I just wanted it to be disturbing, you know, the best kind of illustration. It's like, this guy's the most transpired in Star Wars.
In the 35 plus years that artists have been working in the milieu of Star Wars, there's an amazing body of work that's been created by kind of the official artists, from concept artists like Ralph McQuarrie and Joe Johnston to the comic artists that have worked officially. The beauty of this book is that collection now expands with a whole new array of artists who brought their own talent. Noah Buchanan is one of those artists who had really grown up with Star Wars, and as soon as I mentioned it, and I believe he had been referred to me by someone who said, oh, I think Noah would be good for this project, he said, I'm in.
One of the wonderful things about being an artist, plus a Star Wars fan for me, is that my earliest memories of drawing and painting are based on Star Wars imagery. And I immediately thought, you know, one of the most compelling moments of film, you know, regardless of like science fiction and Star Wars, is the whole scene in the original Star Wars film where Luke is brought to Obi-Wan's house in the desert, and the lighting in that room is silver white pure light, and it's like different than any other moment in any of the films. It reminded me of the light that I also admired as a painter. I finally got down to that moment where the character of Obi-Wan pulls the lightsaber out of its hiding place that he's been holding on to for so many years and gives it to Luke and says, this is your father's lightsaber. And that moment, to me as a child, was so rich, so I realized that's where I wanted to go with my contribution to this project.
Thanks to Abrams, we have a fantastic looking book. Because we couldn't fit all the art into it, standard hardcover trade edition, we decided to do a limited edition, which comes with five prints signed by Jamie Wyatt, Donato Giancola, Alex Ross, Daniel Green, and Mobius.
Over the years, we've done a lot of great art books in Star Wars, but there's never been anything like this that has combined such a diversity of styles and interpretations and fresh, unique perspectives the world of Star Wars.
I think this book is going to go down in the annals of history as a very important book, because 200 notable artists took their own take on this movie, which is fascinating. These are very, very deep-seated, very interesting people who are making an observation that is going to be looked at now and down through history. So this is going to be an amazing collection of works by some very serious artists.
Gracias. Thank you.